I think Paul McCartney does it better, but hey,
not in this setting. In this setting. Thank you, John.
First song I ever wrote. Sitting on the banks of a lazy little stream. Oh, how I wish it wasn't a dream. That's all I remember. I was 19. I'd have been 1957. I was 13 years old. I was at a Presbyterian church camp, and I went off one day by myself walking along the little Colorado River and wrote this song.
And you say that the battle is over, and you say that the war is all done. Go tell it to those with the wind in their nose who run from the sound of the gun. And write it on the sides of the great whaling ships or on ice floes where conscience is tossed. With the wild in their eyes, it is they who must die, and it's we who must measure the loss. And you say that the battle is over, finally the world is at peace. You mean no one is dying and mothers don't weep, or it's not in the papers at least. There are those who would deal in the darkness of life. There are those who would tear down the sun. And most men are ruthless, but some will still weep when the gifts we were given are gone. Now the blame cannot fall on the heads of a few. It's become such a part of the race. It's eternally tragic that that which is magic be killed at the end of the glorious chase. From young seals to great whales, from waters to wood, they will fall just like weeds in the wind. With fur coats and perfumes and trophies on walls, what a hell of a race to call them.
I think that we've become more and more blinded to the natural way and order of the universe, which is in fact big enough to include everybody and everything in the diversity of life, in the myriad forms that it takes. Coexistence is not only possible, it's the natural way. There is harmony. And I think that where conflict has arisen, it has come out of these mind games that we have played to ensure our survival.
And you say that the battle is over, and you say that the war is all done. Go tell it to those with the wind in their nose who run from the sound of the gun. And write it on the sides of the great whaling ships or on ice floes where conscience is tossed. With the wild in their eyes, it is they who must die, and it's we who must measure the loss. With the wild in their eyes, it is they who must die, and it's we who must measure the cost.
God says, I made the world to work. Click. You know the little light bulb that goes on in the comics when you have an eye? That rings true to me. I believe the world was made to work and that it can work. But God says, I look down and the rivers are full of filth. You can't breathe the air, the water you can't drink. You're killing all of my fishes. Click. Sounds a little familiar to me. God, well, why don't you do something about it? And God says, why don't you do something about it? It's your world. Click. I believe it's up to us to solve the problems that we face, that we cannot depend on divine intervention or a miracle occurring someplace. God, but we need help. And God says, that's why I gave you each other. I don't just believe. I know that we are here for each other, not against each other.
Why are you calling this the third world? I only know that it is my world. Maybe someday it can be our world. Can you imagine one world, one world, yeah? This world is made for everybody. This life is given for everyone. This earth is bound to keep on turning. This day is flowers in the sunshine, sunshine, yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Why are you calling this the third world? I only know that this is my world.
See, I think it's a very interesting time in the history of life on the planet Earth. I think that there are actions being taken, there are decisions being made today that are going to affect not only our lives, but the lives of all future generations. In fact, the potential of life itself on this planet. And I think that it's critically important that whatever occurs in these years ahead, that it be an honest and an accurate reflection of who we all are as human beings. Not just Australians, not just Americans, not just Japanese, not just Russians, but human beings. Whether the struggle is to end hunger in the world, or to stop the senseless slaughter of the great whales, or to... or to disarm the nuclear bomb that hangs over all of us, or to preserve the right of any and all people to their natural heritage. The responsibility is ours, and the time is now. Therefore, choose life.
We are fighting for more than survival. We are working for more than peace. We are giving ourselves to each other, making sure all injustice will someday cease. You can take a look around you, and you can see how far we've come. All the separate parts, all the hundreds of hearts that are beating together as one. It's a possibility for many tomorrows. It's a possibility of a world to be made for everyone. It's a possibility. No more suffering and sorrow. It's a possibility. It's in everyone. It's a possibility for many tomorrows. We're a possibility. The world's really made for everyone. We're a possibility.